Howdy, cowboys and cowgirls. I'm Cowboy Jack, and I'm on this giant recycling truck. Wow! This is going to be a crazy fun recycling adventure. Today, I'm here with FCC Environmental Services and our old friends from Residential Recycling and Refuse of Texas. This is their giant, big old recycling truck that I rode in on. Wow! And hey, you know what? I've got some other cowboys and cowgirls here with me. Hey, guys, come on over here. Are you guys excited to learn about recycling and how it's all done? That's really cool. How about some high fives?
I learned about it in first grade.
You learned about it in first grade? Well, now we're gonna get to do hands-on. Isn't that cool? Hey, there's something really cool that we always do here on the Cowboy Jack Show, and that's we jump, spin, and yell yee-haw. You think you guys could do that with me? Wanna do it on three? We'll go one, two, three, and then we'll jump and spin, okay? One, two, three. Yee-haw! Yee-haw! All right, well, it's raining. We better get inside. Come on, guys, this is gonna be great. Wait a second. You guys notice that these kiddos are wearing something really nice? This is a hard hat to protect our heads because we're in a big industrial facility, and this is a high visibility vest. I'm just wearing my brown vest. That's not gonna work out. Let me see if I can get some safety equipment. Wow, look at that. My very own FCC Environmental Services hard hat. I better put that on my head. Can't wear this cowboy hat anymore. Hey, wait a second. Are you guys laughing at my hair again? Ah, stop it. All right, let me get this on my head real quick. Whew. How's that? Look good? I know it's not my cowboy hat, but it's gonna work just fine. And this high visibility vest is really important because there's a lot of big machinery, just like that big recycling truck that's gonna be backing up in here. And you know what else? They got some big, big tools that we're gonna get to take a look at. And I wanna make sure they know where Cowboy Jack is so we don't get in danger's way. This is all gonna keep us real safe. All right. Well, hey guys, thank you so much for coming out today. This is gonna be a whole lot of fun. I appreciate it. All right, we're here at FCC Environmental Services. You know what that means? These guys handle all of the recycling for the city of Houston. So we're bringing in this Residential Refuse and Recycling of Texas truck right here, and they're gonna unload it, and we're gonna push it into a big giant pile so our friends at FCC can sort it all out. Wow. Hey guys, come here. Take a look at this. You see what that is? That's a gigantic pile of recycling. And they sort through all of that to make sure it gets in its right spot here at FCC. We're gonna get to see this truck dump its load, and we're gonna move all of that recycling off to a different destination. Guys, come over here. See behind me, they've got that big dump. I don't even know what you call that, some kind of backhoe that's moving the recycling from this giant pile into that hopper that's gonna move it up a belt that we're gonna take a look at. But right now, this truck is gonna dump its load. All right, cowboys and cowgirls, have you ever seen a recycling truck dump its load before? Come right over here. Let's come over here so we can see what lever he pulls. Wow, look at all these levers. They each do a different job. Whoa, look at that. See, and that's all recycling, just like it got collected from your house. Wow, look at that. And see, it looks real dirty right now, but all this is gonna be put back to good use. Kinda like my vest today, this high-vis vest that I'm wearing, actually made out of old water bottles. Whoa. That is so much recycling. You see, just like the truck is pushing it out, when they pick it up from your house, they smoosh it together real tight so they can fit a whole lot of homes worth of recycling. And peek back here real quick, and then we'll go back to looking at the truck. This is a ginormous pile of recycling. Wow. Okay, get back to the truck. Sorry for the distraction. This truck has so many different moving parts, and everything that's being moved right now is moving because of hydraulics. Isn't that cool? Guys, look at this pile. So all of this came out of that truck. We talk about this a lot. Cowboy Jack is about 6 feet tall. This pile is every bit as tall as I am because there was so many homes recycling and doing their part to protect the environment. Isn't that really cool? Wow. All right, cowboys and cowgirls. Well, now that the residential recycling and refuse of Texas truck has dumped its entire load, and it is so huge. Wow. They're gonna bring this loader over here. Check out that machine. That's called a loader. And they're gonna use that to move all of this recycling into that even bigger pile. Wow, that machine is huge. Look at it go. All right, cowboys and cowgirls, here comes the loader. And he's gonna take all of this and push it all the way over to the drum feeder over there. Wow, that's a big old scoop. That's a really strong machine, isn't it? And that drum feeder, so he's gonna put it up top right over there, and that's gonna be carried by a belt upstairs where we're gonna go see again. Wow. He lifted it up really, really high, and it took no effort at all, thanks to the hydraulics in that truck, in that loader. Wow. Here he goes again, another big scoop. And now he's hauling it off to that drum feeder, dumping in there all the way at the top. He's got a big important job, because he's got to keep that drum feeder full of products going up that conveyor belt that we're going to take a look at, and make sure the folks all the way upstairs, you guys see, it looks like you can see some people all the way in that little room up there in the plant. Those guys are sorting through the different types of recycling, plastic, paper, all that stuff, and separating it out. So he's got to make sure they stay busy by keeping his bucket filling up the drum feeder. Guys, wow, so we're standing right next to that giant drum feeder. That's what this machine is. Isn't that cool? I mean, it is huge. It's driven by these big electric motors. But come right over here, I gotta show you this. So what that drum feeder does is from the other side, he's loading it with that loader, and then he's putting it in there. This actually grabs it all the way from the bottom stacked in there, and then it's coming out and going all the way up this conveyor belt. Guys, look at that conveyor belt. That is so cool. And see, it keeps it very level because it's going into that room, the sorting area, where everybody's sorting it from paper and plastic, just like we talked about. We're gonna get to go up there and actually check it out. Come on, let's go. So we're about to go up to the sorting platform where all those people are working to sort things out. It's up these really big stairs. You guys wanna come with me? Now, like we said, safety is real important. So whenever we're going up the stairs, we're gonna try to maintain 3 points of contact. That's at least 1 foot and 2 hands or 2 feet and 1 hand all times. And if you wanna sneak a peek, there's the conveyor belt still coming up all this way. All right, we're getting closer. Oh, guys, this is so unique. Look at this, and here we are at the top of the conveyor. All these things are going into the sorting center up here at the sorting platform. All right, cowboys and cowgirls. Well, now that we're up here at the top, we've got a couple of big, important pieces of machinery. This is the cardboard sorter right here. As the material moves up that conveyor belt, this grabs all of the cardboard and pushes it off this way. At the bottom of it, they have what they call a glass breaker. What do you guys think a glass breaker would do? That's right, it breaks glass. And so all the glass is gonna fall down and go through this crusher, and it pulverizes it into little tiny pieces that can be reused again. And then some of the other things, like bottles and cans, continue on this belt, and they'll go over the top while all of the paper goods fall down. It's all part of the sorting process. It's really, really neat. And see, guys, this is where the cardboard comes over. So everything you see going down this belt is gonna be cardboard. And that guy in there is working really hard to make sure that it's only cardboard going through there. See, even that bottle was about to make a pass and he grabbed it before it could get down there. So you've got everything from your dog food boxes, if they get a delivery from Chewy like Cowboy Jack does, and all your Amazon packages, anything like that. It falls from this conveyor right here all the way down there to the next conveyor where it continues on its journey. Wow, you guys see this? This looks like all of the paper goods. So this would be like magazines, junk mail, things like that, that comes all the way down here, and it moves to its next spot too. Hey guys, did you know that they even use robots to help sort the recycling? This is their robotic detection device, and as you can see, this is all mixed paper coming down here. Mixed paper is like the recyclables that actually end up getting turned into things like pizza boxes and other types of packaging. And the robot here helps make sure that none of that bad stuff gets through and lets the workers know, hey, you need to grab that so it doesn't get mixed in there. This is really cool. I mean, we've got conveyor belts all around us. Here's another one right over here, and it's moving really fast. That's even more stuff moving by. And as you can see, they're trying to get everything that's not paper out of there. It's not a perfect system, but you try to do the best you can. And there's machines down the line that do give us another step in the process too. Come on, let's keep exploring. So this is a lot of big machinery moving all over the place. There has to be a central hub where all that is taken care of. And that's this device right here. This is like a control panel for it. And they're monitoring everything that's going on constantly and checking it out. See, there's the glass break that we talked about, a vibrating screen, the glass cleaning area, a bunker OCC. I don't even know what that means yet. And then they've got everything down to a trash compactor, and then all of their bins, where when it's finally sorted, that's how they divide it up to ultimately get turned into new products. That's so cool. There's so many different conveyor belts, it's hard to even keep track of how all of it works. But this is like the very automated part of it. All these things are happening by robots, computers, conveyor belts, mechanical equipment, a lot of different stuff. Wow. As you can see, there's not a dull moment anywhere. There's constantly movement. Wow. I mean, look down on these conveyors here. That's really crazy. You've got one, two, three different conveyor belts running right below us right here. Wow. Look at this one here. That even's kind of funny because it almost looks like tire tracks on it. But they use that to grip the product so it'll move it on up. Uh-oh, another stairwell. Remember the rule, 3 points of contact. Wow. So all of those other devices move at kind of a slow pace. This one can move 1,000 units per minute. Isn't that crazy? It's coming over the top kind of slow, but look down here. It's moving really, really fast. That's even faster than Cowboy Caden can run. So this area is real important because you see there's still some aluminum that gets moved to this point. There's some jets of compressed air through there that detect any metal coming through and any cardboard. The metal gets to drop down. The cardboard gets blasted to the other side so it doesn't get mixed in there. Boys and cowgirls, see, this is where all of the water bottles and plastics like that are coming down. And what we're doing here is we're watching for anything that's not a water bottle, any of that kind of plastic, and grabbing it out and throwing it in this trash can here. Let's see if anything comes down. See, there's a, whoop, that's not it. The machines are really efficient at doing their job, so you don't get much down here. But every once in a while, you find something that doesn't belong and you pick it up. Now see, all of these products are sorted out and compacted really tightly so they can be used in new products. And they stack them right over here. So out of the entire city of Houston, that's a ton of recyclables all the way over there. See, they have it broken up. You see a pile for rigid plastics, steel, aluminum, HDPE, which is high density polyethylene. High density polyethylene with color in it. PET, I don't remember what the name of that is. And then mixed paper and OCC and other products. Wow, really, really cool. We worked our way all the way to the very top of the plant, the recycling sorting center. We sometimes would call this the crow's nest, like on a pirate ship. We're the highest point in the building and we can see everything from here. Did you know that in here they have over 2.5 miles of conveyor belts running around? Just like this one here, 2.5 miles, that's a whole lot of conveyor belts. And also, you guys want to guess how many electric motors they have in this building? You think it's 50, 100? It's actually 200 of them moving all these belts and equipment all around. That is so neat. Just look all the way over here and see, it's kind of a lull in the loading process because they're having a shift change right now. So there's not a ton of materials moving up and they're actually going to stop running those belts here in just a second. So it'll actually be a little bit quieter in here. But this is just so amazing to see. I mean, can you imagine? Let's talk about this for a second. So you put your recycling out, that same day the truck picks it up. They load that into one of those trucks that we saw back in here. It gets crushed up and then dropped on the floor. They put it in that hopper and it gets sorted by all these wonderful, nice people and machines to get to be put into recycled products, kind of like my vest I'm wearing or this hard hat I'm wearing. It's really, really cool. Hey cowboys and cowgirls, just put it into perspective how huge this sorting facility is. Let's look down there. That's actually a bale of paper that's gonna be recycled. Those little machines down there running around, those are full-size forklifts, and that's a real human driving that. It just looks tiny from all the way up here because we're real up high. Those bales can weigh up to 2,000 pounds and he's moving them around without any problem whatsoever. That is really neat. And so they stack them all up in here. They get put through this compactor so they're even more contained. And then they'll get loaded onto trucks and taken off to where they're actually recycled. So much activity here at the recycling sorting center. It's incredible. All right, cowboys and cowgirls. Well, all of that paper we saw moving along those belts and getting sorted has come all the way down here. This is called mixed paper. And it's all been squished and all the cardboard has been compressed and put together into these really tight bundles. Well, they don't call them bundles. When they come out of this compactor, they cut them into what they call bales. And these bales are so big, like Wow, look at this. I mean, this could be something like an old piece of... Look at this, guys. Come here. Look at this. So this right here is an old piece of notebook paper, just like you would use at school. And it went from your recycling bin this morning to when you set it out on the curb, picked up by a truck, and compacted into this gigantic bale here. And now all of these trucks, these forklifts are gonna pick up these bales just like this and come on this skid plate, pick them up, and then put them into the back of these trucks so they can go be made into more paper, more boxes, all kinds of different things. Rather than cutting down a new tree and having that turned into cardboard and things like that, we're reusing it. And that does a lot of good for our planet. It's really, really important. This guy on the forklift right here has a real important job. He's taking these bales of plastic bottles and he's gonna load it into one of these 18-wheelers right here. Wow, that's a really tall stack of bundles of water bottles. It's even taller than Cowboy Jack. So he's gonna come back right here. Wow, he makes it look completely effortless. You have to have a lot of skill to be such a good driver. Wow, look at that. And he drove it into this 18-wheeler trailer and he's gonna push it all the way as far forward as he can. Look at that. That's really cool. And guys, come over here real quick so you can see. I mean, they have 18-wheelers full of all kinds of stuff. Take a peek right out here. So just to put it into perspective, whenever you see an 18-wheeler or a semi, as some folks call them, going down the road, you never know what might be inside. It might be full of all kinds of things, but recycling is one of them. All right, cowboys and cowgirls. Wow, we've had such an experience here today at FCC Environmental Services. I'm standing right here. All of these cans, bales are right next to me, are all like soup cans, dog food cans, and those really hard metal cans. These all the way back here, this is aluminum cans like you would have your Coca-Cola, your Sprite products, all of those types of soda cans that we drink. And each one of these cans makes up a bale. There's approximately 52,000 cans in each of these bales, and they can weigh up to 2,000 pounds per bale. That's a whole lot of weight. Well, let's go back over here. Wow. I mean, this is just crazy how much recycling is here. And this is only a few days worth. That's insane. Well, you know what? Now that we're done today, let me go ahead and change my hat. Whew. Hey, wait a second. Are you guys laughing at my hair again? All right. I got my cowboy hat. It's been so much fun with our friends at FCC Environmental Services and our old friends here at Residential Recycling and Refuse of Texas. Wow. So make sure you're following Cowboy Jack on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Cameo, all of those things. And click the subscribe button right below because it really helps us out. All right, cowboys and cowgirls. Well, until next time, I see you. Yeah!